morning all of you. Welcome back to our course Big Data Analytics and Business Intelligence. So our today's topic is introduction to word count example in case of a Hadoop. In last lecture we discussed about various fundamentals of a MapReduce. Now in today's lecture we are going to discuss example of a MapReduce. So here we take a example of a word count by using a Hadoop which involves MapReduce. So this is a brief overline or outline of that particular word count program. So in this case you observe that we are going to provide an input as a text file, because in this case our main aim is to count the number of words present in that particular file. For example, this is what the input file that we are going to provide. So first of all, it will perform a split operation where we have divided this into a three subparts. Then this will be given as an input to the mapper, where we are going to divide this data into a key value pair. Here value that we are going to assign is a 1, because here we need to perform a word count. That's why here for every word we are assigning the value as a 1. Then after that there will be a shuffling and sorting operation will be takes place, and then this is given as an input to the reducer. Reducer will aggregate it and finally you get the output. So this is how overview of a word count program. Now we will understand the Hadoop exam MapReduce word count program in Java. So what are the packages and classes used in this particular program? First of all, we'll understand what are the packages and classes we required for word count program. So here you can see these are the various packages are there: import java.io, util. Then these are the three packages which are present in Hadoop: common.jar. This is a jar file where these packages are present. So here we have Hadoop.io. That IO package is responsible for input and output operation that we are going to perform. Then we have Hadoop.configuration. Configuration package is used to set a configuration for that word count program. Then fs.path, this particular package we are going to use to set the input and output path. So all these three packages are present in the file Hadoop common.jar. Then again we have three more packages, such as a MapReduce, which is very important package because we are dealing with a program of a word count using a MapReduce. So we required a package of MapReduce. Then file input format and file output format. In order to give a input as well as in order to get the output, we need to use a file input output format. So all these are packages which are present in the Hadoop MapReduce client core.jar. These are the two jar files that we required while we execute this particular program, because this common.jar file consists of this package and MapReduce client core.jar consists of these many packages. In order to run this word count program, you required these many packages. Then next one is map and reduce class. As we are discussing this word count program with the help of map and reduce, so it involves two things. One is a map and second one is a reduce. So we will understand we understand the signature of map class as well as the reduce class. So here we can see public static class map extend. So mapper is a super class which is already present in that particular package called as a MapReduce, and here we are creating our own class as a map. So this class name is a user defined. We can provide any name, but we are creating this map function and we are extending super class mapper. It takes four argument. First one for input. In order to get the input by this mapper, long writable, its type is long writable and text. And for the output, we have the data type as a text and integer writable. So similarly for reducer, we have four arguments. Reduce, in order to create a reduce class, it accepts four argument. Two for input and two for output. So here input type is of text and integer writable. This is same as that of output generated by mapper, because we know that whatever the output generated by mapper, that will be given as an input to the reducer. So here in case of mapper, we have output in the form of key value pair and their type, their data type is text and integer writable. So same thing we are going to use in the reduce class also, text and integer writable. And finally we get the output whose type is text and integer writable. So in this particular word count program, we are going to make use of two class. One is a map class and second one is a reduce class. Now we understand map class. Okay, now next is we need to understand the map class. So here, what is the name of our main class? Public class word count. Word count is a main class that we are creating, because this program is a Java base. We know that Hadoop was developed in case base language as a Java. So this public class word count. Word count is a name of my main class program. Main class. Then public static class map extend mapper. So map, just we have seen the signature that we are going to create one map class by extending mapper class. Mapper and reducer, these are two super classes are available in the package called as a map reduce. So it accepts four argument: long writable, text, integer writable. These are the types of variable, or you can say types of data that we are accepting. Then public void map. Map class include a map function. Okay, here we are going to use a map function, which again takes three variable as a input. First of all, first variable is a key of type long writable. Second variable value whose type is text, and third variable is context whose type is context. So these are the three variables that map function is going to get. Now next one is string line equals to value dot to string. Okay, so whatever the particular input we are taking, we are converting that input to the string. For example, I am giving input as a I am Nisarga MI. This is what a complete line I am giving as a input to this map function. So first of all, this particular line is to be converted to the string, and then it will be stored in the variable called as a line whose type is of type string. Okay, all of you getting what we are doing? We are providing input as a particular line. Say, what is a line? I am Nisarga MI. This is a line that we are providing as a input. So first of all, we are converting this input to a string, and we are storing this into a variable of type string. That is, line is a variable of type string. Then next one is we are going to use string tokenizer. String tokenizer is used to separate the words, or to recognize the words in that particular line. Suppose this is what a particular line, so in that case I need to identify the word separated by the space. In this case, separator act as a space. So what is the role of string tokenizer? String tokenizer is used to recognize the words present in particular line, because this line I am giving as an input to this particular program, to that string tokenizer. So I am going to create one object of a class string tokenizer. So tokenizer is an object of class string tokenizer, and to this tokenizer we are giving this line as a input, because line is a variable, we store this complete line. Then we are applying a while loop in order to check whether number of more tokens are available or not. So here what we are writing, while in bracket tokenizer dot has more token is a function which check whether particular whether word is available in the given line or not. Once the number of words in the line get finished, it condition get false, and as soon as condition get false, we'll get out of this while loop. So has more token is a function which check whether word is present in the particular line or not. Then we are going to use value dot set tokenizer dot next token. Whatever the word or token that we have identified in the given line, we are storing into the variable called as a value, and whose type is a text. Okay, after that we are writing this as a output, context dot write value comma new integer writable as a one. As I told you, in this case, as this is a word count program, so we are assigning value as a one for every word. Okay, so let's take an example. suppose this I am Nisarga, am I, this is a line that we are giving as an input. In this case, first of all, we have key and whose type is a long writable because it is a byte offset. Initially, to that map function, we are giving input, and that input is what? First of all, key is there, byte offset is there. That byte offset is given in hexadecimal format. That's why its type is long writable. And then next value will be there. This is what the value, and this value is of type text. So what is the value? That value is nothing but a complete line. I am Nisarga, am I? Okay. Then here this tokenizer will work. So first of all, what we have token. So here what will give I as a one. Don't consider this second one because this second one is for this particular I. Here I have combined this, but don't get confused. How it works, I am going to tell you. First of all, which particular word is present in that particular line I. So what is the output of this value dot set? It will identify I. Then context dot write, it will assign integer variable as a 1. So I comma 1, this is a output of this first iteration of while loop. Again this loop will iterate, again it will check for next word. So second word is m, am. So again this particular value dot set will identify the token, so token is m, and then it will assign 1. So this first one will be assigned to m. Then again this loop will continue, it will again find third word, that is Nisarg. So again here we'll get a token as a Nisarg, and its value is a 1. Again it will go to that loop with, it will check whether further words are present or not. After Nisarg, again m is there. So again it will set m as a 1. Now this second one comes into existence. Okay. Again it will check whether words are there or not. Yes, I. Now this is for, it will identify word as a I and it will assign the value as a 1. So this is what a second. So don't get confused. Here I is repeated for twice, m is repeated for twice, but Nisarg is present only for 1. So that is a role of a map. In this case, what we have done, we have created one class called as a map, which extend mapper superclass. And in this map class, we are going to write a map function. And what is the output of this mapper? Mapper will generate key value as a output. I 1,1, m 1,1, Nisarg 1. So this is what the output generated by map class. Now we'll discuss about reduce class. Okay. Now reduce class will take input as a output generated by map class. So now we'll discuss about reduce class. So here we have written public static class. We are writing class as a reduce, which extend reducer superclass present in the package called as a map reduce, and it takes four argument: text, integer writable, text, integer writable. So first two is for input and last two is for output. So here again we are going to create one function called as a reduce, and it takes three arguments as a variable. First variable is a key of type text. Second variable values of type iterable. Iterable means list. In this case, value is a variable of type iterable. Iterable means list, and whose type is of integer writable. And finally, third variable context. This is for writing the output. So here we are going to take one variable called as a sum. It is just like a counter. We have initialized our counter to zero because our aim is to count the number of occurrence of word, because our aim is to word count program. Suppose I am giving input as a one line, it gives me output the word along with their occurrences. How many times particular word is repeated in that particular file or in that particular line. So we need to count the number of occurrences of that particular word. So we'll take the one variable called as a sum. So this sum act as a counter and we initialize it to zero. Then we'll take one for loop. Then we take a for loop which accepts, this for loop will accept key value pair and it will check for its occurrence. So here sum equals to sum plus x dot get. So in the in this case we have just seen this is the output produced by mapper. Now this output of mapper given as an input to the reduce class, and here we know that this values act as a iterable. Iterable means what? List. So this is what this is a input given to reducer. Okay, or we can say this is output generated by the mapper. But here this curly braces will represent list, because in this case values is of type list and it will just counting the number of occurrences. So here I is repeated for twice. So first of all it will check the values. This is first one. So here we'll get the value of sum as a 1. Again this loop will iterate. Again it will check whether for I, again value is present. Yes, 1 is there. Now for sum it is equals to 2. Again it will check. Now the word is going to be changed. Now second word will be there, m. Okay, so once we get this, we'll print this I comma 2, then we go for second word, that is m. For m, list is there, so that list consists of two occurrences. Again it will count, the value of sum is 2. Again it is going to print m equals to 2. Again we go to the we enter into for loop. Again we'll check the list for this particular key nisarg. So only 1 is present. So here we get the value of sum equals to 1, and finally we'll out the output. So in this way this program work, and finally we got the output as a I comma 2, m comma 2 and nisarg comma 1. So this is what the output of a reducer class. So here we are using context, because context is used for writing the output. So this is how mapper class is there and reducer class is there. Now main function, in order to make use of this mapper class and reducer class, we required a main function. So in this main function you observe public static void main string args. First of all we have configuration. We have object of this configuration class. Conf is a object of a class configuration. What is the use of this configuration? This configuration is used to set the configuration of a map reduce program for word count purpose. So we required configuration, because in the previous lecture, if you understand, I told you about two things. One is a configuration file and second one is a job. Configuration file is important for this word count program. So that we have initialized with this particular line. Then second one is a job. Now what is a job? You know, in case of a Hadoop, in order to submit, we need to prepare one job and we need to submit it to cluster present in the Hadoop. So this is a particular line where we are going to create a job. Okay, and for that job, main class is a word count, because word count is our main class. Okay, then next three lines are there. These three lines are used, job dot set jar by class, word count dot class. Word count dot class is a file in case of a Java, because in case of a Java we are creating a dot class file. So we are initializing these three things, word count dot class, then we are calling mapper class, as well as we are calling as a reduce class, because we already have seen we have created one map class, we also created a reduce class, and word count is a our main class. So we are initializing, we are calling this particular class. Then we have job dot set output key class. So in this case we have text dot class and output value, because we want our output to in the particular format of key value pair. So we are setting it set output key class as a text class and output value class as a integer writable dot class. Then we consider for text input format and text output format. Okay, because we are taking this, then these two lines file input format dot add add input path. So this is what the input path where my this particular file is present, because this test file is a input to that word count program. I am giving test file as a input which consists of this particular line. In this example we are considering that I am providing one test file. In that test file I have written only one line as a I am nisarga mi. So this is a line which is present in the test file, and this test file we are giving as a input to this Hadoop program, and my output will be stored in this particular file called as a out 998. This is a particular file where I am getting the output, and finally I am submitting this particular job to Hadoop in order to process it in clusters of a Hadoop. So in this way, this word count program will work. I hope you understand all this thing about this word count program. So initially we discussed what are the packages required for word count program. Then we discuss about MapReduce class along with their signature. Then we discuss about logic used in the map class. Then we discuss what logic we have used in the reduce class. And finally we discuss about the main function through which we are controlling all this map and reduce. So I hope you understand this word count program. Thank you.